Hello, and a very warm welcome to LNT Royal YouTube channel. The good news that we want to send to everyone today. Prince Harry and Meghan take a hike with their dogs on a public trail used by hundreds of walkers and walked down Los Angeles. The Sussexes wore bandanas over their faces to protect against killer coronavirus in the first picture of them since their move to the city. The couple, who left baby Archie at home, had parked in a house-lined street before heading out onto the well-trodden community route popular with locals. A security guard with a rucksack kept watch on the pair as they exercised their beagle, Guy, and Black Labrador Oz for an hour. Another guard sat in a car near the trail. Harry protected himself from the heat in a brown baseball cap, sunglasses, a gray t-shirt, and brown suede shoes. Meghan, who was carrying a gold-plated iPhone and a bottle of sanitizer, also wore shades and a baseball cap, as well as white trousers, a black top, and trainers. They both used blue bandanas to comply with new California regulations on face coverings to combat the spread of coronavirus. A source told The Sun, Harry and Meghan seemed in very good spirits, and the dogs were clearly over the moon to be out and about. They were hiking for over an hour, and when they got back to the car, the dogs looked exhausted. Meghan even had to carry the beagle back because he was so worn out from the heat. There was one security guard with them during the hike. When they got back, they put the dogs in the trunk and Meghan drove off. The couple relocated to Meghan's hometown last month. Helping out. They have said their security will be privately funded, following a rollover cost to the UK taxpayer, but details have not been released. The hike came just hours after the pair delivered free meals in West Hollywood for charity Project Angel Food, which is helping critically ill people who are at greater risk from COVID-19. Recipient Dan Tyrell said, "For Harry and Meghan to do this is amazing." He said he suspected something was going on when he saw two blacked out 4x4 seconds on the road outside, but did not let on he recognized the couple as he didn't want to make them uncomfortable. Project Angel boss Richard A. Alb said Meghan got the idea to help them from her mum Doria. He added, "We're completely honored. They were extremely down-to-earth and genuinely interested in every single person they met. They really wanted to go visit these people. They wanted to see them and talk to them, and hopefully put a smile on their faces." It is believed Harry and Meghan are still looking for a home in the posh area of Malibu by the Pacific. Another analysis. Prince Harry is facing several major challenges now that he lives in Los Angeles. Since he announced his intention to step away from the British royal family with his wife, Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, Prince Harry has been optimistic about the entire endeavor. He's spoken openly about his desire to live a more peaceful life, away from the constant barrage of press and media. He has also emphasized that he has no desire for his son, Archie Harrison, to grow up in the spotlight. Things seem to be going well for the Sussexes. Shortly after announcing Brexit, they moved to Vancouver Island where they were staying prior to returning to the UK to complete the final royal duties. However, the media soon learned that Canada was not going to be the Sussexes' permanent North American residence. Instead, the couple has moved to Los Angeles, California to be closer to their powerhouse Hollywood team. However, amid the coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic and being so far from home, Prince Harry is facing several challenges. Prince Harry was optimistic about living a normal life. Prince Harry was optimistic about living a when they returned to the UK to carry out their final duties as members of the British royal family. The Sussexes looked absolutely delighted by their decision. However, royal experts were concerned then that they were in over their heads. Royal expert Camilla Tomini told ITV News, "Of course they are besotted with each other, but that's not to say the love they have for each other and their child in their dream life in North America, that they're not going to face challenges. And that it's not going to be difficult, particularly for Prince Harry to leave everything that he's known. This is an institution he was born into, he knows nothing else." Still, Prince Harry seemed assured that things would go smoothly. He said during a leaked phone call, You forget, I was in the military for 10 years, so I'm more normal than my family would like to believe, but certainly being in a different position now gives us the ability to say things and do things that we might not have been able to do. And seeing as everyone under the age of 35 or 36 seems to be carrying out an activist role, gives us the opportunity to try and make more of a difference without being criticized. Oh no, I think it's much better. Prince Harry is finding life outside of the royal family challenging. Unfortunately, being so far from home and stuck inside in a foreign land has not made things easy for the prince. Prince Harry's close friend Jane Goodall told the Radio Times, according to The Guardian, "I don't know how his career is going to map out, but yes, I've been in touch, though I think he's finding life a bit challenging just now. Thankfully, he has been in touch with and on good terms with his family," an insider told Entertainment Tonight. "Harry has been staying in touch with his father and loves his grandmother. Harry misses his family. Prince Harry is struggling with several things now that he lives in Los Angeles. Being away from his family is going to be one of the prince's main struggles now that he's on the opposite side of the world, and he is unable to travel due to the pandemic," royal expert Katie Nichols said. "With the royals in isolation, there isn't much they can do. Although I suspect Harry will probably be feeling far from home right now, they won't want to take any risks by traveling, and their priority is to keep Archie settled and in a routine. I think they will come to the UK when it is safer to do so." Additionally, while Meghan has experience in Hollywood, it will be a whole new world for the prince. Though the pair had hoped to launch their new Arkwell Foundation that will surely keep them both busy, it is currently put on hold due to the virus. Some of the prince's favorite pastimes will also be left behind. Though Prince Harry and Prince William are environmentalists, they enjoy the royal pastime of shooting and hunting, Dr. Goodall explained. "But I think Harry will stop because Meghan doesn't like hunting. Change is always challenging. Hopefully Prince Harry will find his stride in Los Angeles soon." Another report. Meghan Markle hints at having another baby as she says she wants a pint-sized buddy for Archie. Meghan Markle has hinted at having another baby after saying she wants a pint-sized buddy for Archie, an insider has claimed. One of the Duchess of Sussex's friends revealed they'd spoken to Meghan about the prospect of having more children. The source said, Meghan lit up when she spoke about Archie. She said he's a bundle of energy and prefers playing over sleeping. She joked that he needs a pint-sized little buddy other than the dogs. During her chat with her friend, proud mom Meghan described Archie as a happy baby, who is fascinated with his mini instruments and likes banging on whatever he can. The Duchess also reportedly told her friend that Prince Harry likes to get involved by playing the harmonica to Archie. Earlier this week, the Duke of Sussex opened up about his new life in LA and revealed he rolls on the floor in hysterics with Archie and Meghan while making a video call in his California home. While talking to parents with disabled children back in the UK, Harry admitted, "I can't even begin to imagine how hard it is for you guys. Having one kid at 11 months old is enough." Last year, Prince Harry also revealed in an interview for Meghan Markle's Vogue issue that he'd only want two kids maximum to avoid putting a strain on the environment. In the Heart chat with Jane Goodall, the 35-year-old new dad said he only wanted two kids in a bid to help save the planet. He said, "I think, weirdly, because of the people that I've met and the places that I've been fortunate enough to go to, I've always had a connection and a love for nature. I view it differently now, without question. I've always wanted to try and ensure that, even before having a child and hoping to have children." Please support growing LMD Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. Don't stop. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.